We are at the Lennoxville Quilt Guild Show, right? Correct? Mm-hmm. Okay, and I'm with Hazel Kerr, who's a very talented quilter that's been quilting for a long time. And I wanted to take the opportunity to come here and talk to a few people, and you're the lucky first.
Are you ready? First.
You're the lucky first.
Good.
So we have here a quilt that you've made from your, I hear that you make one almost every year based on your pictures that you've taken, and then you come back home and you transfer them and make your own pattern. Kind of like a photo souvenir quilt.
Yes, souvenir quilt, yes.
And so last year you went to the Maritimes?
Well, this was from a few years back. Mm-hmm. And yes, we went to PEI. We spent a couple weeks in PEI, and I just fell in love with all the lighthouses. So I took many pictures and had them blown up.
And transferred them into blocks.
Mm-hmm.
And so those were all hand-pieced? And
yes.
Hand quilted.
Yes.
So even the traditional aspect of your quilt has also been sewn up by hand?
It's hand quilted, yes.
So there's no machine that has touched?
No.
Okay. So I want to put a little bit of history behind it, because I know that hand quilting is, some people say it's something of the past, but I think it's starting to come up in the present as well, because a lot of people are going into the slow moving and taking our time and enjoying it. So you've been doing that for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to find out more about your history. You say that you started quilting with your grandmother in the 50s?
Well, many years ago. Yeah, in the 50s, I would say, the late 50s.
Mm-hmm. And so were they not any sewing machines there, or she had just chosen to show
you
by hand?
Well, they did have the old treadle machines,
mm-hmm.
but if you used heavy material, they didn't go through the treadle machines very good.
Okay.
So we did most of it by hand.
Mm-hmm. All right. And you started did you start quilting, or did you start by sewing clothes? How did
all sewing?
You started by sewing. Mm-hmm.
Right. I was first given a little block and told to sew corners on it neatly.
Mm-hmm.
So you had to pass that test before you actually got on to making a block for quilting.
All right.
But then we didn't do so much quilting as we did tying. Tying was a big thing in those days.
Because tying would be replacing the quilting of the three pieces together.
The quilting of the three pieces together.
Okay, so there was no quilting like what you're doing there.
No, it was more tying.
Okay.
When you did crazy patch, it was more tying than quilting.
So at the beginning, from what I understand, you were doing a lot of crazy quilts because you were, because of the recession, you were using old clothing and cutting them up and...
The good pieces
and just making them work into a block. So that's what you were doing with your grandmother for several years, only those quilts. So as soon as you got out of the house, it's like, I'm not doing that anymore. And did you jump into that, or what was your evolution? How did you get to that point?
Well, when I was married in 1960, my mother-in-law was also a quilter.
Mm-hmm.
And they had what we call quilting bees. So the ladies of the church would gather probably once a month and spend a day quilting. They would go from house to house, quilting on whoever needed help, quilting with the quilt that needed help.
Okay.
So I got introduced that way back into quilting.
Okay.
And they would set a big frame up on the back of four chairs or rails on the back of their dining room chairs, but they couldn't leave them there for very long. So the women would come probably every day for a week and quilt to help out whoever was needing a quilt. So
okay, so and that was, we're in Sherbrooke, so that was in the vicinity of,
well,
Sherbrooke,
I live in Barrie, and my mother-in-law lived in Island Brook, so
okay,
it was close. But people would come, like if you had friends that were quilters, they would all come to help.
So it was something that was very common in the 60s.
Oh, very common.
Everybody was a quilter.
And you'd have probably 6 to 10 ladies that would come quilting, and they'd all pack a lunch and take turns at the quilting frames. So it was a nice time. You'd swap stories and find out what recipes this one was using. And
it's a completely different.
Yes, completely different.
Yes, it was very social. It was a way for women to just gather.
It was, because the men often went to work with other men, but the women were left in the house. So this was a nice way of the women getting together. And
okay, all right.
Wow. But we're kind of coming back to that, because we do meet, two or three times a month and quilt in one another's homes now, and it's nice just to reminisce. And
yeah,
sometimes we do more talking than quilting, but it's still a lot of fun.
All right, so in the 60s when you started doing the quilting bees, that's when you were reintroduced to quilting and
Yes. Seeing
that there was more than crazy quilting. So you got it. Did you start with appliques right away? Did you start with traditional?
No, I started more with piece quilt,
okay,
piece work. When the children were small, it was easier. I didn't have much time for, we grow Christmas trees, so most of my work was tied up in growing trees.
Okay.
But after the children left home, then I started doing applique.
All right.
And I found out that was my corner.
Your calling.
I loved applique.
And so you did, one year you did the lighthouses, another year you did, I
did all the barns in the area.
Mm-hmm.
And then I did all the houses, the nice old houses in the area.
All right.
So we just whatever appeals to you.
Yep.
Right now I'm collecting for covered bridges.
Oh, that's going to be nice.
I want to do covered bridges.
Yes. Oh, okay. All right. And so now, did you keep all of these patterns? What do you do once the quilt is finished? What do you do after?
I have a box of, I have a book actually of all my favorite patterns.
Okay.
And the others I put in a box and pass them on, because I'm teaching my daughter-in-law to quilt right now. And so she's getting all my old patterns and pieces.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, that's very nice. Thank you very much for
giving me the time.
And hope to see more of your work. I really want to see the bridges.
Yeah.
All right. So thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
So we're back for a second time, because we realized that this quilt did touch a sewing machine.
Yes.
Yes.
The blocks did not, but the framework did. As I went to put on the framework, these pieces were pieced by machine.
Okay. And so when did you start using the machine?
Oh, gosh, I don't know what year. I really don't know.
Huh. It was about the year that Lennoxville Quilters were formed.
Yeah. What year was that, Margaret?
What year was it?
When I was working, so I don't know.
Okay, so circa 1990, a sewing machine entered your house.
Yes.
That's about it?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So that's good. But my next question is, when did the rotary cutter enter your world?
Oh, a long time. I watched other people use it and I thought, I'm never going to use that thing. So I guess around the year 2000.
Around, you gave it a try.
Mm-hmm.
So this was cut with the rotary cutter and sewn with a sewing machine. But you're still quilting it by hand.
By hand at that point.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Very good. All right. So thank you for the
correction.
The correction. And we'll thank you very much.